Hey traders, David Frost, LazyGapTrader.com. In this video, I'm going to show you two examples of morning gap trades from this morning that worked out picture perfect. You're getting a sneak peek of one of them. It's on the screen. It's Alcoa AA. It was a short trade. We're going to go over the chart of this one and the other one in detail in a moment. First, I want to explain exactly what this gap trading strategy is all about. As day traders, we need opportunity. In order to find opportunity, we need stocks that are moving, and the real opportunity exists for the traders that can find specific price levels where these stocks will first be drawn to and have a price reaction from in the other direction. Because they're stocks that are moving, they're moving more than a bread box. They're moving more than a couple of percentage points. We can identify support or resistance points where these stocks have a high probability of having a price reaction in the other direction. So I teach a course, and in the course, traders learn everything they need to know in order to be successful trading the gaps. There's a lot of criteria involved. Which stocks does it work the best with? What type of volume do we typically look for? How much of a gap higher or lower do we look for? How do you trade them? What type of stop loss limitation do we need to have? What type of profit target do we look for? How do you maximize the profit on these trades? There's an entire video module in the course where I teach traders how to turn some of these trades into risk-free, emotionless trades. Alcoa is a great example. How do you squeeze all the profit so far on this short trade as it's going down while keeping risk to a nice fat round number of zero? There's a way to do that. We book some profit along the way and we turn it into a risk-free, emotionless trade. There is absolutely tons of information in this course, but here's the holy grail, folks. Traders learn how to calculate and identify the specific price levels where these stocks will first be drawn to and have that price reaction in the other direction. That's the holy grail. It is the golden goose, and you learn how to come up with these numbers. You see them in these videos over and over and over again, which brings me to the other thing I do, which is give traders an opportunity to get my gap trade sent to them each and every morning at 9 o'clock a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 30 minutes before the opening bell even rings. Now, this morning, we had five potential gap trades on the board. Now, keep in mind, earnings season is about to get fired up, so the trades are going to come fast and furious starting in about a week's time. But this morning, we had five opportunities on the board, and two of them hit their specific price targets. One came close, and one is still suspect. It's RPM, and you never know what might happen later in the day. But the two that hit their levels, the first one was Tempur Sealy, TPX. Now, this one was in the news. One of their competitors is going out of business, so their stock's going higher. So I say gap higher. Resistance levels are $54.58, and then I gave two secondary levels above that. They did not come into play. Stop and profit target is about 35 to 65 cents. Keep two things in mind, folks. Number one, these are minimum profit targets. Number two, when I give more than one support level or more than one resistance level, and these are the same price levels that traders that have taken the course are able to calculate on their own, but when you find and I give two support levels or two or three resistance levels, these are all separate and independent trades from one another. We can have more than one trade in the same stock and more than one profitable trade in the same stock in the same day. We can have reactions off more than one of these levels in the same day. It happens more than you would think. The second one that hit its price target today was Alcoa, AA. Gap higher, resistance levels are $45.27, and then I gave a secondary level above that. We didn't need it. Stop and profit target is about 35 to 65 cents. Again, keep in mind, minimum profit target. You already saw why on the chart. We'll talk more about that when we go back to the chart of Alcoa. Let's start on the chart of Tempur Sealy TPX. You'll remember from the email, $54.58 was identified as a resistance level. Now let's go over what happened. So there was some positive news released yesterday that benefited Tempur Sealy TPX. The stock closed yesterday all the way down at $48.37. The stock was getting a nice big gap higher at the open, so we're looking for a resistance resistance level, a level where there's going to be what's called overhead resistance. A bunch of sellers are going to come into the market and push the stock or reject price in and around that level, $54.58. You can see what happened. The stock went slightly above that level, but not going past the stop loss limitation. And just minutes later, in fact, this was 8 minutes later, the stock is at a low of $52.13. That's a tremendous gain in just 8 minutes. Here's the problem with TPX. It opened slightly above the $54.58 level. I talk about this in the course. We treat these slightly differently, but the point of this video is to show you the power and importance of these levels. This is where we were likely to find, and the probability suggested, we would find overhead resistance and price would be rejected. That's exactly what happened. As soon as price hit that level, it immediately was rejected and the stock came back down as advertised. Let's take another look and in detail at Alcoa AA. So the level from the email, the price level or price target was $45.27. The stock closed yesterday at $41.56 all the way down here, and then it was getting a nice gap higher at the open, and here was our overhead resistance or rejection point, as I like to call it. A stock gapping higher is going to find a level where it's going to stall out. It's going to find what's called overhead resistance, 45.27. Went through it by just a little bit, well within the stop loss limitation, and you can see what happened. We've already made a low of $43.85. That's a tremendous gain from a decline off of 45.27 in the same day. This is just a couple of hours later. Folks, this is a strategy that you can use each and every day for the rest of your trading career. Anyone that takes the course at LazyGapTrader.com can learn everything they need to know in order to be successful trading the strategy. Here's what I'll leave you with, folks. It's the why behind the strategy. Once you understand why this works, and you understand the why behind this strategy, you remove the guesswork away from trading. You have a different confidence level when entering trades because you have a different expectation of what's supposed to happen at very specific prices. You remove guesswork and add back in confidence, and that changes your trading for good. If you want to learn everything there is to know about how to trade the gap successfully, come over to check out the course, folks. I'm David Frost, Lazy Gap Trader. Thanks for tuning in.